What's good? Dreycosting. So I've decided to drop some gems on you guys today. So this video that I'm gonna roll out is market structure. It's the first thing that you need to know when trying to trade anything in the financial market, whether it be Forex, stocks, cryptos, commodity, etc. It doesn't really matter, right? So it's an old video, right? Very old, because I've been doing this for a very long time, right? So it's an old video, and within this video, the audio is a little bit choppy. The visuals is a little bit choppy as well. But nonetheless, it's the gems that matter. You know what I mean? So it's very lengthy, you know what I mean? Because it's me teaching a class live, but it's the gems that matter, right? So this covers the first session within my academy on market structure. Well, obviously, within the sessions within my academy right now, the video of market structure is about 20 minutes, right? But I was teaching live here, so it makes it more lengthy. I just really wanted to release this educational material, right? To show people that you have to get the right education, right? And what you're going to learn right here, it might be somewhat on YouTube, I'm there about, but it's not really there in everybody's face, you know what I mean? It's not all over the place. It's rare, you know? So it's just a glimpse in my world, just to show you guys that here, what? Take a deep breath. You don't know this thing as yet, right? You have to understand anything that you want to do in life and to be successful and making some money, you have to be educated. No education, no money. No education, no money. Whether you're gonna be a doctor, lawyer, whatever it is. A physiotherapist, whatever it is, you have to have the education. No education, no money. This is probably the only industry that I know that people try to get into the industry without education. I can never understand it. And you're gonna pay for education one way or the other. Either you're gonna pay a mentor or you're gonna pay the market. And truth be told, paying the market is normally about 10 to 20 times, probably about 100 times more than paying a mentor. So, hope you enjoyed this video, right? Comment below, right? I'm going to be dropping a lot of gems on YouTube going forward, you know what I mean? So, you guys need to subscribe, right? Click the like button, right? Build up the algorithm. That way, you know what I mean? That get me highly motivated to continue to push out quality content. And if you're not following me on Instagram, please do so. All right. So just big up everybody, and I hope you enjoy the video.
Night, everyone. Good night, everyone. Welcome to the first session in your newbies course on market structure, right? If you get what is market structure and how market structure work, then I'm going to be straight up right away. You're halfway there, right? And the reason why a lot of people fail to move forward in trading is because they don't understand how market structure work, right? The market moving a specific structure at all times. So let's show you what's up, right? So this screen right here, right? Watch me now. Have you guys seen this within your Discord, the newbie section? All
Yeah, I've seen that.
right.
Yeah, I've seen that.
All right. So this is what you call market structure, right? Within the market structure has, hold on. Market structure has four phases. All right. four phases are the accumulation stage, advancing stage, the distribution stage, as well as the decline stage, right? So within the accumulation stage and the distribution stage is where the market consolidates, right? What do I mean by consolidation? I'm gonna tell you afterwards. So what? In a nutshell, consolidation is when the market starts to move in a sideways fashion. It's not trending. So whenever the market is trending, it's trending at the advanced stage as well as the decline stage. So we always try to look to take trade within the trending stages of the market structure, which is the advance and the decline stage, right? So let's go back here. So this is what it looks like. The starts right here, right? This is the accumulation stage right here. Then it goes into the advanced stage, right? It goes to the distribution stage, then it goes to the decline stage. The accumulation stage, this is located at the key support level, while the distribution stage is located at the key resistance level. And I'm going to show you how we're boxing the markets to pick out the key supports and the key resistance. So that's one of the first things you have to identify within a market structure. Where is the key support and the key resistance? All right? You guys get that? Any questions so far about the four stages of the market?
Yes, yes.
All right. Sharina, get that? Chantel, you get that?
Yes. I noticed you have the accumulation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. In bracket, you have consolidation and for distribution, you have consolidation. You could have just expound on that a little.
All right, I'm gonna get into it now, Brent. All right.
All right, cool.
So where we are. All right. So the market goes in an uptrend, then it goes into a side trend, then it goes into a downtrend, right? So this right here is what you would call a distribution stage. It is at the key level, right? It's when the market moves in a sideways fashion. So whenever the market moves in a sideways fashion like this, we see that the market is consolidating, meaning it's not trending, right? So we don't look to place orders within the consolidation stage. So let's go again. We don't place orders within the consolidation stage. We place orders within the advanced stage as well as the decline stage. You guys get that? You guys getting that?
Yes. Yeah.
Got it.
All right. Don't worry. It's going to all make sense when I put it on the graph, right? So let's go again. Can Chantel, what are the four stages in the markets? Chantel, can you hear me? Hello?
Are you hearing me?
Yeah, I'm hearing you now. Go ahead.
So it's decline, distribution, advancing, and accumulation.
That A word. All right, great. Keisha, where is the accumulation stage located? Is it located at key support or key resistance? Keisha?
Keish, is that me? Yes, Keish. Okay, repeat the question, please.
Where is the accumulation stage located? At the key support or the key resistance?
I believe key support.
All right, key support, all right? All right, that sounds like a very, very nice guess, all right? All right. So Maya, what comes after the distribution phase? Maya, can you hear me?
Maya is not with us. Just left.
Just left? Okay.
Maybe she got kicked out or something.
Okay. Sheldon, what comes after the distribution phase?
I know it's not even a spear member new, you know.
Well, Sheldon, everyone here is new, Sheldon. That's why it's called a newbies class.
All right, cool. Don't Jen.
All right, nice. All right. Yeah. So let's go back to you right here. So basically, let me show you about the feature. See there, the accumulation stage is at the key support, and it goes into the advanced stage, distribution stage, and the decline stage. Doesn't this just sound so simple? Ask yourself this, right? If you know about market structure, you know that price goes up whenever it comes out of the accumulation, and it goes down when it comes out of the distribution. Don't you realize that you have already won the war before you even start? Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. Seems pretty clear.
Yeah. Brent, does it seem clear to you?
Could you repeat that?
Hold on.
Very clear. That is clear. So far.
Okay.
From accumulative to advance to distribution to decline.
Good. That's so the market goes in this cycle and it repeats the cycle over and over.
Yeah.
All right. Who asked me to repeat a while ago? A female asked that a while ago. Which female asked that? Can you go again? No, I'm not here, the person. All right. So let's move on. All right. I'm checking one more time. A female asked to repeat something a while ago. Can you go ahead, please? All right, so I'm going to break it down now, right? So let's break down the accumulation stage and the distribution stage for it to operate, right? So the distribution phase and the accumulation, they're moving a sideways fashion. So it doesn't go up and it doesn't go down. It moves in a sideways fashion. This is what we call a consolidation. You guys get that?
Yes.
Yeah, copy.
So basically saying that the market is not trending. So let me repeat again. We do not place an order, all right? So let me put this right here, all right? We do not place an order in the consolidation. All right, let me see if I have anyone, let me see if someone can answer this question, and this will tell me how much of reading and listening you guys have been doing, right? What really happens in the market that will make a peer consolidate? Why does a peer consolidate? And at what time of the market does a peer consolidate?
Low volatility.
Go ahead, Sheldon.
Consolidation, I think, is caused by low volatility when there is not enough movements happening in the market.
All right.
It's outside of that peers session.
All right. So simplify it then. Where the newbies can and more persons who would really just start can understand.
But just a start that may understand.
Don't you understand? All right. All right. Sherry, why would you think a market consolidate?
When the spreads are wide. That's what I understand.
No, yeah, the spreads are wide at that time, but that is not the reason why it consolidates. Keisha, you have any clue why it consolidates? Ish?
I kind of understand it close to what Sheldon just said. When the market is, should I say market, is more volatile or vulnerable. What's the word I should use right there?
Non-volatile.
But I think is that.
All right, so let me simplify it for you guys, right? You see, this time when it's consolidating, right? The banks are not in action. Everyone that's here needs to go to my YouTube video that says how and what moves price in the market, right? The quality of the video and the production is really poor, but the information is really great. All right. In terms of quality, I'm going to start out the quality and production on my YouTube and everything as of next week. All right. So what I'm saying though, you guys need to go. It has not the best views, but it's by far the best video I've ever put on my YouTube channel. And I will stand by that video strongly. How and what information. I'm going to post it in the newbies channel so you guys can watch it, right? What information drive price action? Price does not as a brain for itself, right? It's moved by information, right? So at this time in the market, Sheldon, you're close, but the answer that I'm looking for at this time in the market, there's no information to move the price, right? So the type of information that comes out and moves the currency market are like the economical information, such as, quick example, gross domestic product reports, inflation report, job claims reports, right? Those type of economical information is what moves the currency market, while the stock market is when the you guys see me post it on my Instagram and so on, and in the channel, is where the financials, the earnings report come out each quarter for a company. The financial statement information, that is what drives the stock market. So that is why the stock market moves much slower than the currency market, because the information that comes out on the stock market comes out quarterly, while the information on the currency market comes out daily. That is why the currency market moves much faster, is because the information release much faster. You guys get that?
Okay, yeah.
That's what I just said a while ago, guys, is key, pertinent. That's one of the reasons why many people are not successful in this, because they don't understand that simple information. Price does not have a brain for itself. It is moved by information. So to sum up everything that you just said now, Sheldon, to make everybody else understand, whenever the market is consolidating, the banks are closed.
Right.
The market of that era is closed. The banks are closed. Little small man, that's why I see every, I don't know who follow me, and that's why I vent energy. Little small man like us cannot move the market. It's the banks.
One money a week.
Yes, it's the banks that move the market. It's the banks move the market. So at what time of the day would you see this consolidation? For like the Europeans and GB peers, the London session run from 3 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. So anytime after 11 a.m., coming down to the close of the London session, it starts to consolidate, and it consolidates all the way back until when the market reopens and the information is coming out, it starts to move again.
Oh, okay, makes sense.
All right, so we explain all the accumulation and distribution moving in a sideways fashion. Gonna break down now the advanced stage, right? Advanced stage. So this is a rule now. Watch me now with the advanced stage. The definition of an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. Let me go again. The definition of an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. You cannot go for a buy unless the definition for uptrend has been confirmed. You guys get that? You cannot go for a buy unless the definition of an uptrend has been what? Confirmed. Maya, you get that?
To an extent, I'm just reading through what you said about basic trading, that first part. I know a little about higher highs and higher lows.
Now let's get to it now. I don't want to know to what extent everyone has to get it 100%. Watch me now. It is an uptrend. Right, this is what you call a cycle. Right, so let's break it down now. Right, let me go to this. Right, watch me now. Market structure. I have a key resistance here. And you have your key support here, right? So let's start that in. This is key resistance. Right? This is key support. Key support, right? So what happened is this, right? Price consolidates here at the key support at the accumulation stage, and price does this. It goes into the advanced stage, creating higher highs and higher lows. Then it goes to the key resistance, right? And it goes into that consolidation phase. And this phase is what we call the distribution phase, moving a sideways fashion. Then move from the distribution phase and come to the decline phase, creating lower highs and lower lows. Right? And then it starts over the process at the accumulation phase and repeat this process all over again. You guys get that?
Crystal.
Yeah, man. Definitely.
So I'm saying, yes. Maya, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
If price moves like this all the time, wouldn't it be easily predictable to know where price is going? Because after all, that's what trading is all about. Just picking the right direction where price is going and enter it to profit.
Yeah, that's correct. Based on the graph that you showed, that basically, yeah.
Yeah, so if you know where price is going, you're already 50% win the trade already, correct?
Yeah.
So we know that after the accumulation stage, price goes in an uptrend. What I'm saying to you, definition of an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. Keisha, talk to me. Are you getting it?
Yeah, I believe so, yes.
Getting it?
I'm cooking. Sorry, what was the question?
Getting it? Series of higher highs and higher lows?
Yeah. Okay.
Shireen, you getting it?
Yes.
Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Chantel, you getting it? Chantel, can you hear me? Chantel, you're on mute. Sheldon, are you getting it?
Crystal clear, fam. Crystal clear.
All right. So let me go back to this right here, right? The definition of an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. So let's focus on the uptrend. I'm saying to you this. This right here is what you call an impulse. This right here is what you call a retracement. Whenever price made this impulse, you cannot jump in the trade and say, oh, price is going up, and just jump in the trade, right? That is incorrect. You have to wait on the basic of trading of an uptrend to be confirmed with a price to retrace to form a higher low. And at this stage, you can go in here. Does that make any sense, Brent? Brent, are you with me?
Yeah, man, I'm here, man. May I write notes while you talk? See if that, but.
Yeah, write notes. I remember the record. The recordings then posted, yeah, Brent, so it's going to always be here, all right?
Yeah, but.
I watch my Brent now.
Yeah.
That being that you're, you know, the profession that you have, right? So let's look at this. I'm going to make it more clearer for you, Brent, right?
Mm-hmm.
Watch the runnings, all right? Sheldon, this is so clear for you to watch me now. Keisha, everybody, watch me. Follow me now. This is a stairs going up, correct?
Yeah.
You know about stairs now, always going up on them from the right, Brent, don't it?
Yeah, man.
What a reasoning now, right? For a reason now. Watch me now. If you are going up the stairs, you'd expect to go, the steps to get higher and higher and higher, correct?
That's right.
Look at, doesn't this look the same thing as what we're talking about?
Yeah,
simple logic in our life. Watch me. Higher highs, higher highs, higher highs. Mm. Higher lows, higher lows, higher lows.
Right. Yeah,
no. Shireen, you get the simple concept?
Yes, I'm getting it.
All right, Keisha, are you getting it?
Yeah, man, I'm getting it. I got it. Thanks.
Amaya?
Yeah, got it.
All right, watch me now. Let's go back to this now. Watch me now. The definition of a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows. Right? Definition of a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows. You guys get that?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Let's go back to here, right? This is a stairs going down. So if you're walking down the stairs, don't you expect it to get lower and lower and lower?
Yeah.
This high is lower than this high. This high is lower than this one, right? This low is lower than this one. This low is lower than this one, and so on. Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
Watch me now. All right. So let me read that out. Accumulation stage, sideway motion, right? I'm saying to you, if price does this, would you go in for a buy, Sheldon? Can you see it going up?
Absolutely not.
What do we want to confirm?
I want to confirm higher highs.
All right. Watch me now, Sheldon. In terms of confirmation, right, for the uptrend, let me put in this one. Go to look at the higher highs, but look at what we look at, right?
Yeah.
Confirmation for uptrend. Is assessing if a higher low was created. Forget the high, right?
Okay.
All right. Confirmation for a downtrend is what then? Let me see if you're rocking with me.
A lower high.
Lower high, exactly. All right. Lower high. All right. Sharine, you got that so far?
Yes.
All right. So I'm saying to you, whenever price does this, that's one of the mistakes young people, they say, oh, price is going up, and they jump in, and guess what? Price does this and retrace and take them out their stop loss.
True.
You cannot jump in the trade as yet because the basic of trading has not been confirmed as yet. So when price does this retracement, right, is at this stage you go in and go up. You'd enter here. Because at this stage, Brent, it has created a higher low, right? It has created a higher low, right? And a higher high. You get that?
Yeah.
Where am I comparing this low to, Brent? I know you must be saying, how do I know it's a high low? Comparing it here with where the first impulse was from. So this right here, where what we call the previous low.
Previous low.
All right. This is the previous low where it moved from, right? Uh-huh. This is the previous low where it moved from, right? Shift here, and when it retraced, it created a higher low. So this low right here, Brent, is higher than this one. So that is why we know that we are in an uptrend, because the basic of trading has been confirmed. Notice the choice of words. Basic of trading, not the basic of Forex. And we're going to get to that later in the course. So what I'm saying is that this, what I'm saying is the basic of trading. First of all, I should have said this at the start of class. The technique that I'm going to teach you throughout this course, it works for everything. Forex, stocks, cryptos, commodities, right? What I'm leaving out? I'm leaving out something? All instruments you can think of. The system that I'm going to teach you works for everything. I teach a universal system. So when I say the basic of trading, I'm saying to you that this can be applied to stocks, Forex, etc. Not the basic of trading Forex, the basic of trading. You guys get that?
Yeah.
All right. What about the ladies? The ladies get that?
Yes.
All right. So let me go back. So I wanted to get that point out of the way. What I teach is universal. All right. So therefore, shifts again, retrace, right? So say that you didn't enter here. You cannot enter when price is going up. This is what we call a moving train. So you need for it to retrace. Rest, and when the train stops, this is when you can go in again. So if you didn't get to enter here and it's moving, you cannot enter again. You have to wait for it to retrace. This is what you call a retest. Why we call it a retest? Because we are comparing it, right? So this is a higher low.
Yeah.
Right? We are comparing it, right? We are comparing it to this low. So this was a higher low. So this low now, Brent, right? Follow me now. This low now. This low now becomes the previous low.
Yeah.
again that concept. So this was the previous low first, created a higher low. Shifted again. Now this one becomes the previous low, and this now becomes a higher low. You guys get that? All right.
Yeah, I'm on. Clear, man. Clear, clear.
All right. So I'm saying price moves like this. Higher highs, higher lows, higher highs, higher lows. This is what you call the advanced stage. Advanced stage, right? You guys get that?
So the option is basically the same as that, right?
Yes. So the option is called the advanced stage. The downtrend is called the decline stage, right?
Yeah.
You guys get this? Everyone get this? Keisha, you get this?
Yeah, man. I think I get it. I really get it clearly. So basically, what I pick up from what you're saying is that we really don't want to jump in the trade when you see that eye to eye, but really more eye lows
are
low eyes.
Yes.
When it's accumulating and when it's decreasing, that's the word we use, decreasing or...
That's called consolidation.
Consolidating. So you really focus on those two aspects. That's what I summarize.
Yeah, the advance and the decline. We don't enter trades in the consolidation phase. Because you don't enter trades in the consult phase. You can easily be stopped out.
Yeah, that's the stage where the bank is like not active. Oh. That's...
All right, great. All right.
Yeah.
So let's go again. Watch me now. Why wouldn't we want to enter a trade like that? Watch me now. Price does this, right? Price does this. You jump and enter the trade here, right? What can happen is this. Price can now... let me not do it like that. All right, to make one higher low and then... You try to enter in the middle right here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's you enter in the middle right there. You need to wait on it to retrace and form a higher low. What can happen is this price can now break its previous low. And if price breaks its previous low, it can now start to make lower highs and lower lows.
Decline.
Exactly. So right there, you'd have been stopped out and lose your money. So that is why you should not enter here on a moving train. You should enter when price retrace and form a higher low. And it's at that time you know you're in an option. You realize it looks like the stairs going up?
Yeah.
All right. So let's go over to the other side, right? Distribution right here, consolidation. Watch me now. The definition again of a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows. See? Lower highs. You cannot enter in the trade when it does this. It's the opposite, right? You cannot enter right here. Have to wait for it to retrace, ensure that it does not break this previous high, right? And it now forms a lower high, then you can enter here and push down. You guys get that?
Yeah, you can not clearly. You can just move right up there.
All right.
Yeah, so, yeah, right there.
Follow me now. The downtrend is simply the opposite of the
uptrend.
Yeah. So at the option we're focusing on lows, right?
Mm-hmm.
To see if it's creating higher. So if the downtrend is the opposite, we're going to focus on the highs to see if it's getting lower and lower. So this was the previous high right here. Let me break it down. This was the previous high, right? I'm saying to you this, Brent. It shifted and retraced. Price did not come and break its previous high. Because if it came and break this previous high, there's a possibility that it's going to go in an uptrend. So when it came here, it made a lower high. And that is why you'd enter here. Because at this stage, when it created a lower high, Brent, the basic of trading would have been confirmed for a downtrend. Right, so let's go back. Watch the basic of trading. Basic of trading. The definition of an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. Definition of a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows. The same thing with the stairs, right? So if you're trying to be confused, guys, just think of this. Does this feel like I'm walking down a stairs? You know what I'm saying, Ben? If price does this and does this, that doesn't feel like you're walking down a stairs.
Yeah.
If you're walking down a stairs, you expect things to get lower and lower. All right, correct, Shireen? We lost Shireen? Shireen, can you hear me? All right. Keisha, you got that point?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, okay. Who does speak over there? Shireen?
Yes.
Okay, so you got this point, right? So if you're walking down the stairs, you expect it to get lower and lower, correct?
Correct.
All right, Sheldon, you get this point?
Crystal clear, bro.
All right, nice, 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 nice. All right. Yes, Maya, get that point?
Yeah, I got it. I have a question, but go ahead. I'll ask after.
A person was asking a question before, Maya. Who's that?
Keish.
Hi, Keish. Go ahead.
All right. So this is a confirmation or clarity. All right. So when you say lower eyes, higher lows, all right. May I touch upon the thing like Yasimi? Sorry. Can you trace over that part where we're going down with the declining previous eye?
Okay, so you want me to go over it?
Yes, that section, okay. Yeah.
So I'm saying this is the distribution phase right here, right?
Yes, I get that.
After the distributor, remember the market structure, work. Accumulation, advance, distribution, then decline, right?
Yeah, decline.
So I'm saying to you this, after the distribution phase is going to come the decline.
Yes.
The decline is the same thing as a downtrend, right?
Yes.
So this is in the newbies as well, right? So I'm saying to you, definition of a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows.
Yes, I get that, right? Mm-hmm. But when you're saying the best time, can I see about that chart, please? When the other one, please.
Yes.
Yes. So lower highs. Lower lows,
mm-hmm.
going down. So the best time to go in is lower eyes, right?
Yes,
that's what you were explaining.
Yes, you're comparing the eyes. So for a downtrend, you're comparing the eyes, and for an uptrend, you're comparing the lows.
Lows. Okay.
All right. So that's why I have it right. So confirmation for an uptrend is assess it if a higher low was created. Confirmation for a downtrend is assess it if a lower high was created.
Okay.
This is my question, Dre.
Go ahead, Sheldon.
The confirmation, what are those?
Go again.
So in order to take a sell, you're mm-hmm. saying that we have to see that a lower high is created.
Yes. Right?
Good. So we have a impulse movement.
Mm-hmm. Which is this?
Right. And then price is now doing the retracement, right? So for us to get the confirmation that it is forming a lower high.
Yes.
What is this confirmation? Because in the retracement probably don't, let's say the retracement is something like go back to where the impulse movement came from. Would that be considered a lower high just the same or is the same high?
No. Cannot consider a lower high. That means the definition of a downtrend would have not been confirmed, so you would stay out of the trade.
Good. So how we confirm that lower high?
From once it don't break the previous high.
So if it comes just below that high, right, just below.
So let me go. So if price does this, right? If price this is the impulse, and price does, and so this is the previous high right here, right? So if price does this and break the previous high, you cannot enter the trade for a sell. Because the basic of trading was not confirmed.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get that.
Because in order to go in a downtrend, right, you have to have lower highs and lower lows.
So
if price does this, retrace and create this right here, then you can go in right here.
All right.
So that is why you're always comparing the highs to ensure that the previous high was not broken. Same thing over here. Same thing over here for the uptrend, right? Same thing over here for the uptrend, which is you're comparing the lows right here. You're comparing the lows to ensure that when it retraced here, it did not break this previous low. Because price could have done this and break the previous low, and if you break the previous low, that is not an uptrend. So you'd have to wait for the entire action to take place again. You get that, Sheldon? All
right, no, I'll get that. I appreciate it.
All right, Brent, you get that?
Yeah, I just wanted to ask something though. Like when it's declining, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you want to enter into the trade. If you enter, because may I use the concept of a staircase? If you enter at the lower high, isn't it going down? So wouldn't I be basically losing?
Oh, stick a whole heap of in, Brent. What are you popping? This is not stocks.
Okay.
This is not stocks. So remember the knowledge video them, Brent, go through the knowledge video them, right? I have the first video on my channel called What is Forex, right?
You can watch that.
Yeah, go through it, all right? Remember, in the Forex market, or not even just the Forex market, but the difference between out here locally, and the trading platforms, you can make money both ways.
That is good.
Make money when it's going up, and you can make money if it's going down. The objective of it is to know the assets if you get the direction right or not. So it's simple. I'm placing an order saying that this is going up. If I get that order, if that prediction is correct, I make money. If it does go up and like come back down, I lose money. Ain't in here. I'm predicting that price is going down. If it goes down, I lose money. Yeah, man, if it goes down, correction. If it goes down, I make money, right? So, but if it does something like this and goes back up, I lose money. It's all about predicting where price is going. That's it.
All right, boss. I get it.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying right here that I started off with this. If you understand market structure work, you're already 50% away to your winnings because you already know the direction where it's going. It's just all about where you're going to enter now. And that is why I came to the second step to show you that you cannot just enter because it's going up. You have to wait for it to retrace. This is what we call a moving train. You have to wait till the train stops. You ever see a moving train or a train is moving fast? No. You cannot just jump on the train. You have to wait till the train stops. Right? Then you go on the train. You guys get that? All right. So I know you guys are excited now to see this live. So let's show you live now, right? So this is a chart, trading view. If you guys have not created a trading view account as yet, the link is in the newbies channel, right? Or you can just click on it and create a trading view account, right? This is what we use to assess our chart, what the chart is doing and so on, right? So I'm looking at this chart. This is up here that's called USDJPY, right? So I know you are saying to yourself, this is so confusing, right? Talk to me, guys. This looks so confusing, correct?
Yep.
It was for me. It was for me once upon a time. It was for me.
Who said that, Brent?
No, I mean, so that's all.
Oh, because Brent show off, you know.
Brent not get it, man. Brent not get
Brent
it.
Brent show off, you know.
Don't bother with that. Brent not ask the question, them.
All right, Brent.
It was.
Brent, remember, we have international people on the line as well, yeah?
It was for me as well, but...
No, I can't use the word of
Okay.
Yeah.
Brent is learning.
All right. So watch me now. So let's go back to the basics, right? Watch me now, right? First thing you want to do, so in order to identify the market structure, for me, you have to identify, let me put in this note, right? You have to identify the market structure using the higher time frames, right? You guys get that? So you cannot use a 5 minutes or a 10 minutes or a 15 minutes or a 30 minutes to identify a market structure, right? You got to use 4 hours, 4 hour charts and above, right? You guys get that? So I like to use a 4 hour chart to identify my market structure, right? So the first thing you want to do is to box in the market. What do I mean by boxing in the market? Let me go back to this right here. Right? We want to box in the markets, right? Watch me now. You're going to look across, right? When you look across, you're looking for a key level. What, right? A key level where price bounces on, right? And respects. So right away, if you look here, right? If you look here. So anytime you guys see me put out a chart, you can use whatever lines you like to use. But those who trade with me, right? I always use the blue lines, right? I use the blue lines for the key levels, right? This is what you call key support. All right, so making a little sense now? You guys get that? Key support? You guys get that?
But what does it mean to box in the market?
All right, so in order to, gotta finish box it in now, right? So after you get your key support, you're gonna look for your key resistance. So this is what you call your key resistance. Why are these key? And what does it mean to box in the market? That's a good question. Brent, I'm gonna pick one again, right? Yeah. Watch me now, Brent. The last time I pick on Kurt, I use cars. So let's use horses, right? Let me pick on you, right?
Yeah.
Watch your reasoning now. Oh, forget international feature. Let's analyze this now, right?
Yes, sir.
If you're buying a house, right, in the ghetto, right, the price range for the houses in the ghetto is about, what you call it again, they're about, let's say, 10 to 50,000, right?
Yeah, low, it's low. That's so low, but it's low.
That's what you call a range. That's the market range.
Range, yeah.
Where buyers or sellers are willing to bargain. Mm-hmm. Right? You get that?
Yes, yes, sir.
However, if you go to the suburbs, right? If you go to the suburbs, it will be a higher market value, right?
Definitely, definitely.
So instead of from here to here, it probably move from about here, about up there.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes.
So what do I mean to box in? Box in, it means where price where buyers are no longer willing to go higher than that. So let me give you the breakdown the example now with the house now. So the ghetto stops at 50,000, right? Yeah. But if you go to the suburbs, right, prices of the house ranges from 100,000 to about 500,000, right?
Uh-huh.
So I'm saying to you, who asked the question? Kish, who asked the question? Oh, what do you mean by boxing?
Chantel.
Yeah. So I'm saying to you, the Chantel, right?
Yeah.
You go to the ghetto, right? And you see a house selling for 500,000, right? Are you going to buy that house when you can go to the suburbs to buy it?
True.
Right.
Right? So yeah. So what do I mean by boxing is that this is what the key support and the key resistance is boxing the areas where buyers and sellers are willing to negotiate. It's the era, it's called the market structure era of value. It's right here, the market structure era of value, where buyers and sellers are willing to negotiate. They are saying to you that they are not willing to negotiate out of this area. No, no, no. They are willing to negotiate within this area only. You guys get that? Keisha, you get that? Chantel, you get that?
Yeah.
Maya, you get that?
I get it, because I was just about to ask you, when I look at where your blue line is at the bottom there,
mm-hmm.
I see that there's still some weak, you know, further down.
It's not gonna,
so I was wondering.
It's not gonna be perfect. The reason why I catch here is because I look right. When I look right, realizing that price is respecting this line firm.
Yes, that's why. That's why I figured.
Yes, it's respecting there. So let's let's run it now, right? Watch me now. Watch me now. Key support, right? Key support, watch me now. This right here is whoosh phase of the market structure. Sheldon, I'm done with this. So, this one class alone can make him enough money, Sheldon.
Yeah?
One class alone.
The accumulation phase.
Accumulation phase. Stage is this, Maya?
Accumulation.
Accumulation. How do we know that is the accumulation?
Because the market is going sideways, is that right?
No. Remember, the market consolidated two phases in the market structure. How do we know it's the accumulation stage? Shireen, how do we know it's the accumulation stage?
Oh.
Shireen?
Yes.
It's the accumulation stage.
I guess it's going in the uptrend when it's finished.
Exactly. Reason why we know that is the accumulation stage because it is located at the key support. Simple. Yeah. And how do we know that this right here, right? This one right here, this little movement right here, there wasn't much accumulation right here, right? There wasn't much, right? But this little phase right here, it wasn't much. I'm going to give you a better example, right? It wasn't much. This right here was like the distribution phase, right? There wasn't much accumulation. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Sorry, there wasn't much consolidation. But ain't nothing wrong with that, right? I needed to get the concept, which is this, right? Mm-hmm. Let me look right and see what's going on. Okay. It's better right here, okay. The concept I wanted to get is this. It goes from accumulation. Look at this. It goes to the advanced stage. You guys get that?
Yes, sir.
What comes after the advanced stage? Distribution somewhere, the key software, right?
Yeah, distribution.
After distribution, what comes after distribution?
Decline.
What did you see happen right here?
The decline. Yeah, there's a decline there.
All right, decline, right? What comes after the decline phase?
Accumulation.
It's all over again. Accumulation. The key support. Right? What comes after the accumulation?
Advance.
Market structure. So if you understand market structure, you're already 50% won. Does that make any sense?
Done, man.
You guys get that?
Yes.
So basically the stage is all... You hearing me?
Speak.
So basically the stage is always repeats itself.
Exactly.
Okay.
All right, so watch me now, right? The advanced stages are uptrend or downtrend?
Up.
Uptrend. What is the definition of an uptrend, sir?
A series of higher highs and higher lows.
Right. A series of higher highs and higher lows. This one break the lows, so we'd have to wait for it to start over again. Higher lows.
Right.
So I'm saying to you, so let's put it in practice now, right? I'm saying to you this. The market shifted and retraced here, right? When the market shifted and retraced there. Hold on. When the market shifted here and burst out of the accumulation stage, you cannot place an order here. This is incorrect.
It's a moving trade.
Exactly. It's a moving trade. You have to wait for it to come retest. This is what we call a retest. We're going to talk about all of that. So I don't want to get all fancy. This is the retracement, right? This right here, where it shifted from, everyone, is the previous low. And when it shifted, created a what? What it created when it shifted?
Higher low.
Higher low.
Higher, okay.
Higher low. Right? So suppose you did catch this train right here. Kishi, what would you do? You did catch it right here. What would you do? You did catch it right here. This low, what would you do?
That's a way to okay. So that's II, right? That's where I'm seeing your arrow right now.
Oh, this is IOS art. I'm saying that suppose you did catch it when it was going up at the IO right here. Really? What would you do?
Wait till because right now where I'm seeing it's going into a sideway right there. So
it's not going in a sideway. Look at the trend line, it's going up. Look at this trend line right here. This is sideways. This is not sideways, this is up.
I was just talking about that little.
This little right here?
No. So I low is right there where you were at. Mm-hmm. And you said, if I didn't catch it right there, mm-hmm. right? Going, it's going up, then it, I guess I'll wait till it goes I lows again.
Stop right there. Exactly, right? All you're going to do is wait on another retracement for it to create a higher low. Right?
Yeah.
And it's at this stage now, the basic of trading would have been confirmed and you go straight up in your profit. You see that? Let's check from here. See how much pips is that? Let's check from here. From here, you would have entered from to here where price went all the way up here to the key resistance. That's 429 pips. If you had to catch it from here, right out of the accumulation phase and make the first retest, right? Go all the way to the key resistance. That's 554 pips. You get that? Price always moves in the same market structure. It's just that simple. It's no rocket science. Trust me, when I finish breaking down this whole trading thing for you guys, you're gonna be like, Jano, it moves in the same fashion at all times. So let's take something that is much more clear. Next thing I need to identify to you guys. If I cannot identify the market structure properly with the accumulation, say distribution and so on, I move on to our next peer. Simple as that, right?
Yeah.
Simple as that. Because that to show that that peer is not a trending peer and you should stay away from that peer. You guys get that?
Yeah.
All right. Watch me now. The next thing now I need to speak of, hold on before I move on. Does everyone understand what I just show you now on the physical chart of how market structure works? Move your depreciation and it starts all over again. You guys get that?
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
All right. Watch me now. Next thing I must say now, right? So right here, we see where price came down. See where price came down? So at the distribution stage, what happened? Price came all the way down here. Decline phase, it's a long decline phase. And it rests on here at the key support. See right here? Accumulation now. So watch me now. This is where price is, right?
Yeah.
Let me see if someone is smart now. Everyone is smart. Let me see who is thinking ahead, right? Let me see who I want to pick. I'm not going to pick on Sheldon, you know, because why Sheldon do like he want to run left the class. Right. Shereen. So this is much more live now, right? Shereen, price came out at the decline phase and now at the accumulation phase at the key support. Where is price going to go next and how and what confirmation do I need to know where is price going to go next? Easier question. What are you going to do right here? Buy or sell? Buy or sell?
It would be a buy.
Okay, so you go for a buy, right? what needs to happen for you to go for a buy? Go again.
It needs to go in an uptrend. It needs to go in an uptrend.
Okay. And what is the definition of an uptrend?
An uptrend, it's it's higher low and higher low and higher high.
Okay, great. So in order for you to go in an uptrend, it needs to break out of the consolidation phase and create a higher low. And it's right here, you'd go for your buy and continue up to the key resistance. So your take profit would be somewhere about here. Right?
Okay.
You don't need to go all the way up there. You could just take a little small piece right there.
Okay.
Because you know that's going to go here. Question though, why can we go for a sell as well?
It could if it breaks the lower low.
This line, it breaks the key support.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So if it breaks the key support, right?
Right.
What needs to happen for you to go for a sell? What's the definition of a downtrend?
Definition of a downtrend is lower high and lower lows.
Nice. So moving on to the next topic, and I'm so happy that I picked on the sharing. You did well. All right, nice. So the next thing I'm going to move on now is change of market structure era value. But no, Sheila never said that one. Eh?
No, I've never seen that one.
All right, so change of market structure value. Oh, Brent, may I pick on you again? What's your reason, Brent? Right?
Yeah, man. Yes, sir.
Remember, we just spoke about the houses, right? Regular price of the houses in the ghetto is between this region, right? But guess what? No. Recession happened. Recession, Brent. What is going to happen to house prices? Prices if recession happens?
They're going to go way below the market price.
And it's going to move now to a lower market era of value.
Yes.
So instead of it, right, selling between 10 to 50,000, it probably starts selling between 1 to 5,000.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
All right. So, another quick side note, guys. You could if you choose, it's not a must. You could record me while I'm teaching and put it on your stories, tag me. All right. I like those type of stuff. All right. If you choose though. So watch what I'm saying now, right? It's going to move to a lower market value structure. But in order to confirm that it's ready to move to this lower market value structure, Brent, right?
Yeah.
As Shireen said, it needs to break out of this consolidation, shift down and create a lower high.
That's below the key support.
Yes, it has to break this key support.
Mm-hmm.
Right? A low high, then we can go in for ourselves. But how do we find where this key support, right? Before we move on, this key support now is going to become what, Brent?
Previous key support, or it will become the key resistance.
Key resistance because the market structure value has changed. So in order to play, not because price is here at the accumulation stage, you guys gonna assume that it's gonna go up. No, you have to wait on confirmation if it's want to stay within this era of value or if it's want to move to a different era of value and continue the same market structure. So you could do something like this, right? You could do something like this, right? From here, low, high, low, low. Then it starts to come here and it starts to accumulation stage. It starts to come here, distribution stage, and it starts to do, start to work now. Start to do the same market structure thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then this value now. So you have to be careful whenever price is at a key level. You cannot jump in a trade whenever price is at a key level. You have to wait and allow price to come to you. How would I identify this next key level? I already know where this one is at, but how would I identify where this next key level is at? Keisha. Keisha, my wife is keep on reminding me. So Keisha.
It's fine. Keisha is fine. Keisha is okay. What's the question?
So I already know here, right, that this is the key support. And if it breaks here, this will now become key resistance. How do I identify where the new key support is going to be?
Yeah. Yeah. One second.
Right. Sheldon, how would I identify where the next key level would be down here?
How would you identify where the next key level will be?
Yeah.
You look left.
Look left. All right. I see you're watching the YouTube videos, man. You're watching the videos.
I've been going through them, yo.
All right. All you're going to do is just look left to see where price was. Going to continue looking left. And we see right here, right? Key levels, right? So I'll probably put my next key level right here. Right? Here about here. Where it last accumulated, then it went up, right? Then it started to go back right. Just look left to see what happened before. So that's how we pick up the new key supports. Hold on, did you guys just get that a while ago? So this will now become key support. Right, and this now will become the key resistance, which was previous key support and now become key resistance, right?
Yeah.
You guys get that? Charlene, you got that?
Yes.
Or we look left for the new line. If price decides to break here, we have to look left for the next new line. Get the next to box it in. Shantek, you asked about the boxing process. You realize we have to look left to get the next key line? Shantek? Ma, you there with me?
No. Yeah, I'm here.
All right, so you get that, Maya, where we look left to get the next key line?
Understand.
All right, is it clear to everyone?
Clear.
All right, so I'm saying that if price came down here, retest, right, create a lower high, then we can go in for a sell and continue down here, and it's going to come here, accumulation, and it's going to start up here, advance, right, and they're going to move from there, right, they're going to form right here, distribution, right, then they're going to go down, decline, it's going to stay in this era. However, if price does this, right, if price does this, as Shereen stated before, if price does this, bring out of the consolidation, perform a higher low, right? Then we know that price is still staying with this market structure value. You guys get that? And then we continue here for our buy going all the way up. Stop loss right about here. Why? All right. Let me see what I'm going for. Maya, this would be my take profit trying to go in all the way up here. Well, I'm going to put my stop loss right here, just below the previous low. It shifted from. Why would I put my stop loss? If you're not speaking, guys, please to mute your mic.
Yeah, kind of interference just now. I lost you somewhere.
Yeah, let me do that a bit. All right. All right. Maya, unmute yourself, please.
Okay.
All right. So I'm saying to you now, why would I put my stop loss right below the previous low? When it shifted right here, I get a higher low, right? I get a higher low right here, right? Higher low. That's why I went up for the buy, right? why would I put my stop loss right below here where it shifted, where I jumped in from? Why? You know what a stop loss is and a take profit is, Mario?
Oh no, I didn't watch that video.
All right, so let me summarize it quick. So a take profit is where you're telling the broker that take me out of the market in this profit if I'm right. However, if I'm wrong, right, I don't want to lose no more than this amount of money. So if a trade goes against me, take me out of the market right here. So that's what it means. All right. You get that?
Yeah, I got that.
All right. So why would I put my stop loss right here?
Because if it is that the market should go against you, if it's going down, mm-hmm. you don't want to lose any money. So you ensure that you're protecting yourself
mm-hmm.
or protecting your money.
All right. Dear, but that's not the answer I want to hear. All right, let me see who getting this, right? Brent, why would I put my stop loss here? Right below where I shifted from. Where I moved from. Brent, can you hear me? Unmute yourself, Brent.
Yeah, Jay, mm-hmm. my answer would have been the same as what the young lady just said, and not two verse and the right. stop loss.
Yeah. Right, that's not the answer I'm looking for, though. Keisha, why would I put my stop loss here?
That the aisle.
Yeah, I entered here. This is where I entered from, right? This is where I entered from.
Mm-hmm.
I entered yeah. here, right? Entered here, right? Right. Where I put my stop loss here? Am I right? I take profit all the way up here.
Okay, I'm seeing market going up eye to eye right there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's moving.
All right.
So you're saying you basically would exit right there?
Yes. I would exit right here if something goes wrong. I want to be taken out of the trade right here.
Okay, so
if everything goes right, I want to exit up here if everything goes right.
It's like, as you said, it's a moving train. It's going up eye to eye right now. Is it that it's accumulating? That you're questioning if it's going to go back to the normal flow? Is it that? I'm not sure.
Okay. All right, Fernie, Shalom, why would I put my stop loss here?
Oh, Jay, Jano, all right. Why would you put your stop loss there? All right, so this is after the market has broken out of the accumulation phase, right?
You say it says shifted here, retest created a high low. I entered here, right? And I started to go up, but I put my stop loss right below where I entered, below the higher low where I entered from. Just right below it, very tight. Why would I put my stop loss there?
I guess you would have gotten your confirmation for that buy.
Okay, so why would I put my stop loss here?
You would put your stop loss there because...
Want me to give you a clue to the answer?
I think I have it. One second. It just came. It might came to me. In case the market go against you?
Would it who's saying that? Who's saying that?
Keish, I just spoke
earlier. That is the reason for our stop loss, in case the market goes against you.
Well, why would you put it there?
Why would you put it there? I put it down here if the market go again.
Right, exactly. So there's something behind that.
Here.
Is it a trend that you're observing?
All right. Let me give you guys a clue. What is the definition of an uptrend?
Higher highs and higher low.
So why would I put my stop loss right here?
You have a first confirmation of a higher low.
Exactly. So why would I put my stop loss there?
In case it breaks the higher low.
Again?
In case it breaks the higher low.
Exactly. Because if price breaks this low, if price does this Sheldon, comes here and breaks this low, I am no longer in an uptrend. The definition for an uptrend would have been void.
Okay. All right.
So why would I want to be in the trade? Going up, if the definition for an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows.
Right.
So if price breaks low, I am no longer in an uptrend. So why would I want to be going up? I want to come out of the market. It shows that my analysis was wrong.
All right.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So if price does this, goes here and breaks, I want to come out. Because if it breaks that low, it can now do this and makes a lower high, which will then confirm the definition of a downtrend.
All right.
So from once price breaks the previous low, definition for uptrend is void. Right? Get that?
Yeah.
Right? Let's look at the same reason right here. If price doesn't want to send its market structure value and it does this, breaks out of the accumulation stage, retrace, and form a lower high, I'm going to enter, right? So right here is the previous high. Right here is the previous high, right? And this right here is the lower high. All right, so I got in here, right? Watch me now. Got in here. I entered here, right? Follow me. Entered here. All right? I'm saying to you that I'm going to put my stop loss right above here, the lower high where I entered. That is why when you see me make a loss or whatever, it's always minimal. It's common sense. If price voids that break this high, you're no longer in a downtrend. So my stop losses are always tight compared to my take profit. If price voids the definition of a downtrend, why would I want to be going down? The stairs should be going lower and lower, not higher and higher if you want to go down. You cannot be in an elevator, so you want to go down, right? You're at the sixth floor in the elevator. You cannot press 10. If you want to go down, you gotta press one on the ground floor. Right? It's basic reason. Watch me. So I'm saying to you that if I enter here my stop loss, I'm saying to you, price retrace right here. I need it to form a lower high. Lower highs, right? I don't want price. If price retrace here and break this high, I'm no longer in a downtrend, Sheldon.
Copy.
Right? So that's why now we're going to move on to a lot of this thing, but advanced stuff, right?
Yeah.
So I'm saying to you this, right? If price does this, Sheldon, enter from here, and if price retrace, forms a lower high, and then continue to move, I'm still in a downtrend. What I would do now, Sheldon, is this. I would move my stop loss to where it formed the next lower high. So right then and there, Sheldon, I'm in a risk-free trade. So every time it forms a lower high, I put my stop loss right above the lower high. Why? Because at any time the price does this, I'm no longer in a downtrend. Because the definition of a downtrend, Sheldon, is a series of lower highs and lower lows.
All right.
Brent, you see the reasoning? Brent, you get it?
Yeah, man. Yeah, I see the new lower high and stuff.
All right, Keisha, see what's going on?
Yes, got it.
Is it clear? Is it crystal?
Right. Yes.
All right, Maya, you get it?
Yeah, I got it.
Shireen, is it crystal?
Yes.
All right. Don't want to long out the class. Let me see if I've covered everything, market structure, this and that. All right. So that's it for the class, right? We spoke about market structure. Everyone understand what we mean about market structure. What I'm going to do, the last thing I'm going to do is this. And this is not a very clean market structure. This was a bad example. It shows market structure, but I'm going to show you a very clean one. that I'm doing with a German 30, right? An extremely clean one, right? So I'm in this trade right now, right? I'm in this trade right now on the German 30. What do I know to be in this trade on the German 30? Because the market structure, see right here, these two blue lines right here, accumulation stage went up. If you notice, price is moving within this era. Since July, price is moving within. Before July, it was below here at this market structure value in March coming down. You see that? It moved to a higher market structure value and it's within this value right here, right? See here, hit your key support. It's right here, key resistance. What comes after key resistance? Client phase. So all I'm doing is putting my stop loss right at the key resistance. I'm putting my take profit all the way at the key support. That's what? 17,000 pips. German 30. And I'm just going to sit in this trade for the next 2-3 weeks.
Are you doing long term?
I do a different type of trade. I do a long term as well as short terms on the 5 minutes and 15 minutes. So we're going to get to all of those.
Okay.
But I'm always trying to have a mixture of both.
Okay.
But it's the same principle because you have to know where you are in the market structure and job time frame. Because if you're in the advanced stage of the market structure, whenever you job time frame, Sheldon, you have to be looking for buying opportunities, not selling. Does that make sense? Yeah. If you're in the decline phase, the market structure, you have to be looking for selling opportunities, looking for lower items in job time frames and not buying opportunities.
Okay, right.
All right.
Right.
Everyone get that? Everyone get it? All right. Stop share. All right. Oh, thank you guys for being here. All right. And this is the end of the market structure class. All right.